There is only so much safety in the emptiness. Canada is in retreat and in a race against time to find a way out.
There is a real sense of urgency here. And so this is really, a race against the disease.
In the global sprint for a vaccine, Volker Gerst is leading this country's front from the University of Saskatchewan. He and his team are working around the clock and under pressure to move even faster.
The sooner we have a vaccine, the sooner we can prevent people from dying.
Vito Intervac is Canada's vaccine nerve center and is already at a key phase, one of a handful of labs in the world ready to test a vaccine on animals. Next month, a big reveal. Ferrets will be exposed to the new coronavirus to see if the vaccine candidate works.
People are really helping.
A potential turning point for Canada and the world.
And I think the concern that we all have at the moment is whether there's another phase to this or not. And so having a vaccine for the next phase is absolutely critical.
Gerst's team is part of the World Health Organization's effort to halt the coronavirus's deadly spread. He's on weekly calls, exchanging data with scientists from around the world. And researchers are sharing their work on medical servers in real time.
This is a worldwide problem, and this is a worldwide issue that we should solve together. The most important thing in all of this is not to be first.
Virologist Paul Duprex from the University of Pittsburgh is part of that same WHO vaccine network. He says working together is speeding up the process to find a successful vaccine among the dozens in development.
And I'm really glad that we've got lots and lots of different options, because you know what's going to happen? Those vaccines are going to fall at different stages in the testing process. So therefore, if we have backups upon backups upon backups, that allows us to get something across the finish line.
It's critically important to do it faster.
From her office in Toronto, infectious disease expert Alison McGeer says speeding up the research process could save lives.
Whereas normally people would say, well, you know, I'm just not sure about that, and I want to be absolutely sure about it. Now there's a good reason for doing it differently. And if you do it differently and it works, then you've learned something and you can make processes for developing vaccines faster in general, which we'd all agree would be a good thing.
Back in Saskatoon, if the potential vaccine passes the animal test next month, human trials will follow in the fall. A vaccine could be ready in a year, for the world, Gerst says, and especially for Canada.
We're a Canadian team making a vaccine for Canadians, and so it's our highest priority to make sure that this vaccine will be available for Canadians.
Only then, he says, can science catch up with a disease that is still outrunning it. Joanna Rumeliotis, CBC News, Toronto.